How's it going? Today, I'm proud to present to you 2005 BMW X5 E53 generation. This is going to be a full in-depth tour of this X5, all set up, show the engine, go on some performance details, show you a bunch of the interesting features in the exterior as well as the interior. And so, here's the key. Let's start the engine, let it run for a while. Lock, unlock, and trunk button. Black metallic exterior. Very solid doors, very wide opening. Sounds like 90 degree, providing easy entry and exit. This car has 8 airbags. Dark leather interior. Very nice. Full leather wrap, full sports design, multifunctional steering wheel. Nice one, definitely. And this particular has 172,339 kilometers in it. All right, very nice startup. This car comes equipped with hydraulic assist power steering component, very flat steering wheel, horn, very loud, bar tilt and telescopic, very nice. This car has automatic lights. Right now, guys, let's send headlight, front rear fog lights, high beam, swivel set lights, all four windows in this car fully automatic, back direction up and down, clear windows. Very nice. Partners. By the way, huge mirrors. They also heated. Nice. Very nice. Power window lock is right there. Which room? Everything is padded. Let's see. Alright, guys. Let's open the hood and take a look. Take care of this car. Put it right there. Open the hood. This car missing car roof, roof rails. As you can see, back windows are fully tinted. Gorgeous tail lights. Dual exhaust pipes, rear parking assist. License plate lights, rear defrosting glass, rear wiper, deck lid spoiler, third plate light, spoke aluminum wheels, 17 inch, tires measuring 235-65, 4 wheel disc brakes and flaps. turn still on the gas on front fenders. Xenon projector headlamps. Headlight washers right there. Halogen fog lights. This car has inline 6 24 valve 3 liter normal aspirated engine. It produces 231 horsepower, maximum speed of 210 km per hour. The 0-6 time is 8.8 seconds. Combined fuel consumption for this car is around 14 liters per 100 km. The car is 4 wheel drive. The fuel tank is around 93 liters. Independent double wishbone suspension up front and independent multi-link suspension out back. Alright guys, take a good look. The exterior, let's take a good look at the interior portion. Most interesting part. Once again, very heavy and solid doors. Everything's padded. Fake aluminum trim. Twitter's right there. Speakers, still show you. Tire pressure is right there. Warning and caution. Driver's seat has three-person memory, it's right there. Lighting, of course, high. The barn, quite comfortable seats, adjustable headrests, seat belts. Illumination right there. Panel dim is right there. Alright guys, let's see what kind of noise this engine produces. Just awesome. Quite easy to read gauges. Driver information system right there. Consumption. Range. Speed limit. Distance to empty, I believe. Arrival. Your average speed. Date. Timer. Time, digital clock, very nice. And here's your light indicator controls, intermittent wiper controls, it's right there. Press this button. Nice. And here's your auto controls, you can raise and lower the volume, your different settings right there. Voice commands, voice intonation right there, and your cruise control settings. Set the speed. Alright. Build quality and all the materials are just awesome. You can find soft touch plastic, very nice. Hot and cold, rich wood trim, audio with single disc CD, can just tone, bass, treble, so on and so forth. E-check, the squad right there, BMW Business CD. Power button, audio adjustment, your telephone controls, and onboard computer. Clock adjustment. It's quite easy to use, just set it and forget it. Actually, 8 speakers, sounds pretty good. Down here you can find your dual zone, fully automatic climate control, fan speed, your different modes, face, neck, etc., one touch automatic. Everything is very nice put together here. Temperature adjustment, it's quite easy to use. Maximum air conditioning, front rear defrost, recycle settings, automatic recycle, and air conditioning. Nice. Just set it and forget it. Alright. Downhill assist, turn off the dynamic stability control for the trunk, turn off the parking sensors. And tire pressure monitor system is right there. 3-stage heated seats for the driver and for the passenger. High, medium, low, and off. Ladder and ashtray is right there. 5-speed automatic transmission. Quite reliable. Low trim, ladder wrap, reverse. Neutral, drive, also actually, mirrors, tail down, nice, sport mode, and manual steptronic shifting, as you can see, plus for the upshift and minus for the downshift. Central lock. Search down there. Ladder wrap e-brake, very solid. Feels very solid. Central armrest, ladder wrap for your telephone, I believe, and search area down there. Very good size. Coin holders right there. Auto-dim rearview mirror, map lights, microphone, hands-free, sun visors, vent mirror, hood illumination of course, car holder, grip handles, very good visibility, as you can see. This car feels great inside and out. True German quality. Very comfortable suspension. Legroom is more than enough. Thigh support is pretty good, and shoulder is okay. All right, guys, let's shut it down. Let's grab the key and continue our tour. Awesome. very wide open rear doors. Child safety locks is right there. Same bridge watch room. Everything is padded, white stitching. Storage area. Ashtray or garbage tray. Speakers and power window. Back seats are very nice. 60-foot split to increase more cargo space. Child seat anchors is right there. As you can see, completely flat. Alright guys, with my 6'3 stature, quite easy to get in and out indeed. Legroom is not an issue at all. And my headroom is pretty good. Storage is right there. Rear vents, lighter, cigarette lighter, two cup holders, storage area, and there is no center at all. Armrest, soft central armrest. Interior illumination up top. Guard hook right there. Awesome interior. Alright guys, let's check trunk space, shall we? Very thick power panels, as you can see. Feels like a tank. Illumination right there. Trunk is huge, very good size. Split happening, like BMW E70 has and brand new BMW F15 X5. Very nice. Cargo cover right there. Two outlets, fuse box, located right there. Warning triangle, I believe, right there. Warning triangle is missing. Alright, carpets, and down here you can find your spare tire, as you can see. Illumination right there and right there. same power adjustment for the passenger seat minus memory settings. Lockable glove box, very good size, wood illumination, also bed, very nice. Incredible German car. Feels great inside and out. And quite reliable. Well guys, hope you enjoy my in-depth look at this 2005 BMW X5. Feel free to subscribe to my channel, I'm sure you catch up next time. This is where I came from, thanks for watching and take care guys.